Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk mostly about the correct method to correctly project 3D motions onto a 2D character into Cartoon Animator using the Motion Link plugin. On the screen right now we have a 2D character that is already linked to iClone using Motion Link. Let's go ahead and click the Play and CTA button to get an initial look. You'll notice right away that the performance looks a bit strange, so what we'll need to do is adjust the projection angle to fit the 2D character. To do this, we can simply adjust the projection angle to the right position at 45 degrees. You can actually click on the number 45 to snap it to that value as well. In this next example, we have a side-facing character, so if we want the character to animate properly in CTA, then we'll need to set the projection angle to negative 90 degrees. You'll see we get the correct result once we do so. We can also have our character walk the other direction as well by changing the angle to plus 90. However, notice that when we drag the projection angle slider that the character's body will become disjointed. To fix this issue, we can simply click the flip body box and the character angle will then correct itself. If you have flip body box selected, then your character will flip to fix the angle profile as you move the projection angle slider from one side to the next. If you have camera tracking enabled, then the camera will always follow the 3D character in iClone. Let's disable it for now and play back to see the difference. Now, we'll need to zoom out in order to see the full movement forward since the camera will no longer automatically track it. There's also a camera tracking option in the Motion Live plugin in Cartoon Animator, which is enabled by default. This is why the character will always remain in camera even after walking forward. To turn this off, you can find the camera tracking checkbox near the bottom of the Motion Live 2D window. With that disabled, now we'll need to zoom out to see our character's entire range of motion after we re-enable Send to Cartoon Animator. If you accidentally or intentionally adjust the viewport camera angle in iClone, it won't affect the motion sent to CTA at all. However, if you want the view to be consistent with the projection angle you set, you can select the Reset Camera button to snap it back into the relevant view. Let's take a look at the Lock to Hip option next. If we have it disabled and play back this particular motion, you'll notice that there is a little bit of a weird twisting issue with her arms. This is because the 3D character is rotating around so much that the back is facing the camera, so the projection angle is incorrect. This is why we have the Lock to Hip option. You'll see that with this enabled, the camera will always be facing towards the front of the character's hip, which allows us to retain the correct projection angle throughout the animation, since there is limited 3D movement that a 2D projection can simulate. You can see in this example that the red camera on the right is the one that is locked to the character's hip, so it will follow the rotation of the character while always facing directly to the hip. If your 3D motion changes direction a lot, then it's highly recommended to use the Lock to Hip feature. Next, let's take a look at the Enable Z-axis option. You can see with this particular motion that in iClone the character is walking towards us while it remains stationary in Cartoon Animator. In order to fix this, we need to go into the Motion Live plugin in Cartoon Animator and find the Enable Z-axis option. You'll see that once we enable this, that now we have the correct result in Cartoon Animator, and we'll see the character moving forward. You can adjust the strength of the Z-axis movement with the slider as well. If we take it up to maximum, it will appear as though our 2D character is moving further forward than before. You can also see if we play back in 3D view that our character will physically be moving forward in that space as well. Say that we want to do the opposite, and we have a character from the back walking further away from us like you see here. We have a 2D character facing away from the camera in CTA, and if we play back, we'll see it move forward despite being in the incorrect angle profile. To fix this, the first step is to change the projection angle to negative 180 degrees. You'll see that the character gets all twisted, so we need to use another option in the Motion Live 2D window called the Back Character option. Once we select that, then our playback will be accurate and it won't look like the character is twisted or walking backwards. Finally, let's take a look at the Auto Hand Flip option. In this gesture animation, you'll notice that the 3D character will turn its hand, but the 2D character doesn't. If we want that to happen, then we once again need to go into the 2D Motion Live window and enable the Auto Hand Flip option. Once we do that, then our hand flipping will be accurate. Those are all the basic tips and tricks to getting your 3D projection onto a Cartoon Animator 2D character to be as accurate as possible. There are tons of other cool motions to try out these techniques on, so go have fun. Remember to check out our other Motion Link tutorials, as well as our forums at forum.reillusion.com, and I'll see you in the next video.